Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch in the laws of Sefiras HaOmer. Misha Shochach Kol HaLaila. A person forgot to count the Sefira the entire night. V'loy Sofer, he didn't count. So what does he do? Yisper Bayoyim B'loy Bracha. He's still allowed to count during the daytime, but he does it without making a bracha, a blessing. Why? Because the opportune time to count Sefiras HaOmer is really at night. And that's the only time that you're allowed to say a bracha. If you forgot to say a bracha at night, but you remember during the day, you still count, but you do it without a blessing. Ubalelos she'achar kach, and on the nights that follow this, yisbor bebracha, you are still allowed to count with a bracha. So even though, for example, let's say that a person forgot to count last night, and today they count without a bracha, then tonight, the following day of Sefiras HaOmer, you'd still be allowed to count with a new bracha. V'im shachach gam kol hayom. However, if a person forgot to count the entire day, then yisbar achar kach b'chol halelos, he's going to count for the rest of the nights, b'loy bracha, without a bracha. Now you lost the ability to make a bracha, a blessing altogether, and therefore, you still count, because you don't want to miss out on the counting of Sefiras HaOmer. However, you would do it every day and every night without a blessing. Now here's a question. If you are in doubt whether or not you counted the night before or not, and you still didn't count the following day, again, for example, you are in doubt whether you forgot to count last night, and then you're in doubt, and whatever reason, you didn't try to make it up, and you didn't count today either. Mikol makom, nevertheless, yochel lispor shaar halelos bebracha, you're allowed to continue counting on the rest of the nights with a bracha. Since that you're only in doubt whether or not you didn't count, and there is an opinion that says that each night is a new mitzvah in and of itself, therefore you're allowed to rely upon that opinion and continue counting with a bracha. The next halach is Hashem Mechaveh Ben Hashmoshes. Let's say that it's the time of the day called Ben Hashmoshes, which is the transitional period between one day and the following night. So for example, let's say that today Shkia, the end of the day, is at, let's say, 7:35. And nighttime doesn't fully kick in until about 8:10. So between 7:35 and 8:10, so this is called Ben Hashmoshes. So it's not really yesterday or today, and it's not really tomorrow yet. So, but if a person would ask you during that time, which day of Sefiras HaOmer is it? Or they asked you afterwards, meaning at nighttime, they asked you, what is the day of Sefiras HaOmer? What are we supposed to be counting? What number of the sphere do we count? You should respond to him, yesterday was such and such a day. Why? Because if you tell the person how much you're supposed to count today, the person who responded is no longer allowed to make a blessing after that, ala sfira, the counting of that day, because since that he said today is, for example, the sixth day, so he fulfills his obligation of the counting by saying that. However, if he just said the sixth day, he didn't say today is the sixth day, he just said the sixth day, or six, so then he would, by saying that, showing that he's not counting, and you'd be able to share the day with a person in that way. And so too, if you already got to the weeks, for example, it's 7 days and 1 week of the Omer. If you only said it's 7 days and you didn't mention the weeks, so then also in that case you could tell a person which day it is, and that's not going to count as if you counted for yourself. Okay, those are the halachas for today. Be'ez Hashem, we shall continue tomorrow. All the best.